Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about the famous primary text frame. A primary text frame is a special kind of master page frame used to control the primary text flow in a document. You can create it in two ways, one while you're creating the document and the other from within the document. So let's learn how to do it. I'm creating this document and you can find the primary text frame checkbox here. Should you want it applied, just check it and hit create. When you go to A Master, you'll find that both the A Master pages already have the text frames sitting on them. Let me zoom in on the top left border of the page. This is the primary text frame icon. If it was the traditional master frame, it wouldn't have the tiny arrow on the right. Let's move to page 1, and when you click it, you'll find that even your page has the primary text frame sitting there. When a master with a primary text frame is applied, you don't have to override the primary text frame to type or paste text into the frame. Also, the story in the primary text frame automatically flows into the primary text frame of the new master page. Let's fill in some text. So let's go to File and then Place and locate the text file on the computer and hit Open. Ignore the missing font error and hit Skip. Now, since this is a primary text frame, we can click anywhere in the first column and the text will flow seamlessly through the pages. Let's go to page 10 and let's click at the beginning of this paragraph. What we're trying to do is push the text from this paragraph to the following page. And to do that, let's go to Type and then Insert Break Character and select Page Break. And the paragraphs will jump to the next page. Let's say my next page, which in this case is page 11, is chapter 2, and I don't want it to begin from the top of the page because I'll need some space for the heading. To achieve that, I'm going to take my cursor to the master page zone and right-click and select New Master option. In the pop-up menu, the prefix will already be selected as B Master, so just hit OK. Remember, at this point, we've just created a new master, but it does not have any sort of text frame, so let's add them now. Let's go to our A Master and hit Command A on a Mac or Control A on a PC to select both the frames, and then copy them using Command C on a Mac or Control C on a PC. Get back to B Master and paste the text frames here using Command V on a Mac or Control V on a PC. It might not be aligned, so just click and drag for it to shake hands with the margins of the B Master. If you zoom in, you'll find that the frames in B Master have transformed into regular master frames, and that's how the regular frame looks, without the arrow that we found on the primary text frame earlier. To turn it into a primary text frame, just click the book icon once, and you shall find the book icon has a companion now. So it is now a primary text frame. To find if they are linked, you can go to View and then Extras and select Show Text Threads, and the thread will be revealed, confirming the route your text will take to flow. Let's drag our frames down on both the pages to make them shorter, because like I mentioned earlier, we don't really want full pages on B Master. Now click on page 11 thumbnail to select it, and then right click and select Apply Master to Pages option. From the pop-up menu, change the master to B Master and hit OK. You can see how well page 11 received the B Master settings. If you click the text box, you could see how smoothly the text is communicating between both the masters. Let's find out if this is possible using the regular master text frame. Let's go to File and then New and select Document. From the new document creation window, let every setting be intact except the primary text frame. Uncheck the primary text frame box and hit create. Let's go to A Master and using the type tool, create a text box covering the entire page. And before releasing the mouse, hit the right arrow once to split the text box into two. You could clearly see that the icon this time is of a master text frame, hence is missing the tiny right arrow in it. Now copy the text frame and paste it to the right page of the A Master. Since this is the master text frame, the pages will need to be linked. If you go to View and then Extras and select Show Text Threads, you'll find that the two pages are not linked yet. So click the small square box at the bottom right of the page once and then click the column on the next page to link it, and it shall be linked instantly. Let's move to page 1. And unlike primary text frame, you'll find that the master text frame is not active here. You'll have to override it should you really want to select the text frame on the page of the document. We don't really need that, so let's go to File, and then Place, and locate the image on the computer and hit Open. Skip the missing font error and click on the left column and the text shall autoflow. Much like we did earlier with the primary text frame document, let's go to page 10 and place the cursor at the same paragraph and then go to Type and then Insert Break Character and select Page Break to push the rest of the text to the next page. Take your cursor to the master page zone and right-click and select New Master option. In the pop-up menu, the prefix will already be selected as B Master, so just hit OK. Now go to A Master and copy the frames on both the pages like we did earlier, and then paste them on B Master. Let's also shorten the text boxes on both the pages. Since my B Master is ready, let's click page 11 to select it, and then right-click and select Apply Master to Pages, and from the pop-up menu, select B Master and hit OK. You'll find that page 11 is not taking effect of the new master applied to it like it did with the primary text frame. So that's one big reason why you should use primary text frame instead, particularly when you're composing a book or a document that has a lot of pages in it. Alright guys, that concludes our session today. I hope you've enjoyed it and have learned something new from it. So do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.